You know, the most we've ever had in one room, my sister-in-law Gretchen, my niece, the most we've ever had in one room was probably 30 people because we never needed to. And so this time, because seeing hundreds of folks, this is very, very, very gratifying. And so I want to thank you all very much. I'm going to just spend a few minutes and tell you some about myself. Because many of you, this is the first time you've met me. Of course, I know Reg from a good while. And so I'm going to tell you a little bit about myself, why I'm doing this, and why we'll be making this announcement later on this month. Just so you can get a sense, I was born here in Detroit. Now, some of you here are what I call low mileage. When I say low mileage, what I mean by that is you were around back in the 1960s. And if you were, you were very small. But today, unlike it was back then, you know, you can come up into 7 mile level up here. I was born in a place called, a little black hospital called Kerwood. A little small hospital down there near the Art Institute. Black folks had to be born in a particular spot back in those days. And I lived in the projects on Monroe at Hastings. And our family, of course, is the Joe Louis Barrow family. My middle name is Joe because I was paid for by Joe Louis to be born. So we all went known as Uncle Joe. And so we grew up there in the projects down there in Black Bottom. And then they brought I-75 through there.
Yeah.
Now, you all take I-75 for granted. But that was my neighborhood back then. And the Monroe exit that's there now is where we stayed. And then black folks, we had to move out to the east side. But I'm not going to be reluctant to bite my tongue on that whole thing. Because I believe Detroiters can run Detroit. Doesn't mean I'm not inclusive. I absolutely am inclusive. I do not believe I do not like prejudice. I do not like bigotry. But I see that campaign is based on bigotry and prejudice. And I'm not going to be reluctant to point that out. I believe in diversity. Detroit is for everyone. We want folks to come into Detroit, but you got to come correct. You can't come in here and messing up our streets. You can't come here and come wrong. You come here desiring to want to participate. But the solution is not just bust people's heads, stop and frisk, and run up in people's houses and all that sort of thing willy-nilly. That is not the solution. That is, we've been there, done that, got t-shirts from that back in the 1960s. They had stopped and frisk. They had the big four. They had stress. And that's what led to Coleman Young.